So, what is video would like to present to the first side view, which is a workshop that I have created, and they find some people to help me in the organization. So this basically an idea together in a single place, people interested in computational intelligence and computational and the biomathematics and computational intelligence. Despite of the fact that it's not as sometimes easy to see, it is widely applied in in different areas, but not all the time recognized. So basically, each time we have more and more interdisciplinarity, in some way, not to handle problems. Problem biology and medicine are in general non-linear, are rock standard. That means that the kind of the classical technique that we use to solve problem mathematics, which has been done widely by biomathematics, is not always possible to solve like generic problem, and the computational intelligence can be the best option for solving a problem that the can say a classical mathematics is unable to solve. So computational intelligence, on the other hand, is also generic set of tools such as artificial neural network and colonies. They are all based on the same idea that you have some kind of intelligence that is used to solve problem. The name computational intelligence is relatively recent, but artificial intelligence, which some people say that is the same thing, is much older. One example of the computational intelligence technique is the so well-known artificial neural network, which is basically a graph, which is a set of neurons, which are mathematical models that can be used for solving generic problems. This is a classical perceptron, which with inputs, hidden layers, and output. Computational intelligence, biomathematics, on the other hand, is sorry, here is a mistake. Biomathematics. So, biomathematics is a name for biomathematics procedure to biology and medicine. So, biomathematics, which I ask apologies, that's a mistake, is a generic name for applying mathematical procedures to biology and medicine. One example has to do with a paper I was reading recently, in which the person applied finite element techniques for understanding the concept of pain. He's modeling the pain when you apply two electrodes here and apply electricity, and how it goes inside the skin. So it was modeled by this kind of technique is widely applied in material science. So where can you meet problem data section between computational intelligence and biomathematics common in the literature? Example is this conference I participated in 2015, in which have several papers there in the section about the medicine and especially artificial intelligence. This one it was interesting because the use of uncertainty in biomedical models. You can go there and see the paper for more details. I will not present the paper here, but here we have a very short expansion of the paper. You can go there and see more details. We have one example there. The other one is a very nice book I have bought about in 2013, in which you have the application of the fuzzy logic for understand electrocardiogram. That's basically it's an example because you can go to the similarity of the paper. They are able to classify people with diabetes based on the electrocardiogram using the concept of fuzzed inference model. You can go to any detail. So that's the kind of thing. This example might be very advanced, but simple problem can be as well given this workshop. This is just the first edition, is organized by, let's say, initial attempt to put people to make some discussion, so you do not have to think about something very complex like that. We have a simple example, simple idea, everything that might be a contribution. You may try to get that to me in the big language, let you know, give my opinion. So you can contribute by paper submission, by seminar, webinar, by group, just participating. I have changed the deadlines because the previous deadline was very short. But if you are interested to see the paper and so on, please let me know that I can try to give my best to organize. Here you do not have to be PR. I ask my apologies, another mistake. So it's gmail.com.pr. This PR does not exist. My apologies. So that's all. So here there's a final remark. I hope that this workshop is going to work. This, to be honest, that's the first workshop that I organized. I hope that not to be the last one. The topic is can be a challenge, especially in Brazil, because it doesn't seem to have too much of a culture to connect biomimetic computational intelligence. I was really surprised that the workshop was accepted, but since it was accepted, now we have to give our best. I hope that we'll be there by participating, by giving webinars, seminar, or by sending papers that you can present there. So all the best. Hope to see you around.